Similarly, if you look at the lives of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will find them filled with stories of how people traded the life of this world for the akhirah. One such story is that of a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His name was Abu Darda radiyallahu anhu, who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said that I have a garden of 600 date palm trees. Imagine now, 600 date palm trees, what a massive garden he had. And he said that the boundary wall of that garden is weak and it's leaning against a tree of a man so and so who owns that tree, and my wall is being supported by his tree. So Abu Darda narrated the story of the Prophet ﷺ and he said that, please can you ask him to sell me that tree so that I can retain my wall and it does not collapse. The Prophet ﷺ told him that go to that man and tell him that he can give you that date palm tree for the promise of a tree in Jannah. And when Abu Darda went to him and told him this, the man said, no, I don't want to give it to you. So look at now the wisdom of Abu Darda radiallahu anhu. He said, will you give me your one tree for my entire garden of 600 date palm trees? And the man said, yes, of course I will give it to you. He said, give it. The garden is yours and give me this date palm tree. And when he took the date palm tree, he said, oh, by the way, you can keep this one date palm tree because it will help you retain your wall. And he went to his wife saying, oh, my wife, come out, we have to leave this garden because I have sold it for promise of one tree in Jannah. And what did the wife say? Look at the words of the wife. She said, indeed, you have made a profitable trade, O Abu Darda. This is what the wife says. Imagine now if you tell your wife, I've sold everything for Jannah. And imagine the pounding that you get. Look at the state of these companions. Look at what was their world view. Look at how they viewed this dunya and how they viewed the akhirah. He gave up his entire garden of 600 date palm trees for the sake of a tree in Jannah, because he was going to be promised paradise. This is how they lived their lives. We are told in the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ about the person who will be the most wealthiest, most happiest person amongst mankind to have ever existed. The man who was the happiest on earth, who had everything, who had the greatest wealth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have him dipped in hellfire for the fraction of a second. Just a quick dip in hellfire, and then he will be asked that all that you acquired in this dunya, all the happiness that you possessed, how was it? How happy were you? And he will say, by Allah, it was nothing. I will give it all up, but don't put me in hellfire. Imagine, this is the state of a person who had everything in this dunya and what he will feel on the day of judgment. Likewise, a person who will be the worst off in this dunya, a poor person who was mistreated, the unhappiest person on the face of this earth, he will be dipped in Jannah for a fraction of a second. And he will be asked, did you suffer anything bad in this dunya? And he will say, by Allah, nothing bad. I didn't suffer anything bad in this dunya, because if Jannah is what I'm going to get, send me there. That was nothing. So imagine now our state of affairs when we complain on problems and when we rely on our wealth and our children, that this is something great for us, and the problems are, what a problem is this? This is nothing compared to the life of the hereafter. This is how we define success. Because success is defined that we should be steadfast on our deen until death comes to us. Till the time that we die, we must be upon La ilaha illallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ.
And die not except as Muslims. Do not die. Please do not die except as Muslims. If you want success, this is the formula. except as those who are surrendering to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to realize that we need to stick to our covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till our very death. Till the time that we die, we must, the promise that we made before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are our Lord, we must stick to that promise that we made before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has told us in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Azab chapter 33 verse 23,
مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا.
That among the believers are men who have been true to their covenant with Allah. Of them some have already fulfilled their obligations. There are some who have already gotten that promise of Jannah, and some of them are still waiting. Some of them are still waiting to fulfill that covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Holy Prophet ﷺ said that in a famous hadith that this world is a prison for a believer and the only paradise for a kafir, for a non-believer. And we must ponder upon this and reflect upon this very deeply if we are to understand the meaning of this dunya and the akhirah. If we are following the lifestyles of the kafir who are enjoying themselves and all of this razzle dazzle, and we think that we can also be like them and have fun like them and enjoy life like them, know that that is the only paradise that they are ever going to get. This world is a prison for a believer, and there are certain things which we can do and certain things which we cannot do. So we must stop envying the kafir that we want to be like them, we want to look like them, act like them, dress like them and enjoy life just like them. If you want to do that, go ahead and do that, but then do not expect Jannah in the hereafter. Again and again the Prophet ﷺ has told us not to imitate the kuffar. Even in our appearances, not to imitate the kuffar. This is how he wants this ideology to be ingrained in our minds, that do not envy them. You do not know what their end result will be. You do not want to follow the same path that they are following. This is a consistent theme that you will find throughout the Holy Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ as well. Likewise, the Prophet ﷺ defined to us what is a bankrupt person. He asked his companions, do you know who is a bankrupt person? And if we were to answer, we'd say a person who's lost all his money and his wealth. But the Prophet ﷺ defined it as one who collects many good deeds, but on the day of judgment he loses them all because he mistreated one person, abused one person and hurt another person. He will go on the day of judgment with tons of good deeds, but they will be turned to dust because of the things that he did to other people, and he will have to give up his deeds to them in order to compensate them. And he will lose them out until his good deeds are down to a zero. All the backbiting, the lying, the slandering, the hurting people's feelings that he has done, collected, and he lost all of the good deeds that he had done. This is a bankrupt person. You could be a millionaire in this world, but according to the laws of Allah, you could be a bankrupt person in the hereafter. Zero, nothing to show for. The qualities of the successful people, the qualities of the most successful people in this universe have been given to us in the Holy Quran, and we can say that there are many in number, but I'll try to now give you quickly a few of them, let's say about seven of them, which are the qualities of those who are successful. The first four of them you can find in Surah Al-Asr, which according to Imam Shafi, he said that if this was the only surah revealed, it would have been sufficient for mankind.
والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by time that mankind is in a state of loss. All are losers except those who believe, do righteous deeds, guide one another to the truth and guide one another to patience. So the first thing that we must understand is that our iman is number one. Those who believe. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who believe. And iman is a verb. It is a verb. It is not something that we say, oh, I have iman. No. You have to act upon it. It is an action. Iman is an action. You have to do it. You have to show that you are one who believes in one God. You cannot say, I believe, and you're doing all the things which are hated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not Iman. This is not Allazina Amanu. Iman is, you say you believe in one Allah and you show it, it is a verb. Your actions need to show Iman. Your actions need to show taqwa, fear of Allah. It has to be shown in how you live your life.